Hi, and welcome to my tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be going over Security Shepherd Cross-Site Request Forgery Lesson 1. So in this VM, I have Kali Linux. Another VM, I have the OWASP broken web applications with Security Shepherd. And I have two users right here. You can see Attacker 1 and Victim 1. And a brief overview of what Cross-Site Request Forgery is we as an attacker are just trying to get the victim right here to interact with a web application unknowingly. We'll do that by using a forged HTTP request. So let's go ahead and go to your attacker session and go to CSRF1. And you can see the directions are we must get our CSRF counter above 0. Once request increments our counter as follows. Where example ID is the ID of the user whose CSRF counter has been incremented. And then it gives us our ID and tells us any user but ourselves can increment our counter. And then it looks like we have a little form here where we can enter an image URL to share with the people in our class. So if we just look at the SRC of that, we can see it's null. And whenever we put in here, we'll get entered into that SRC. So to do the CSRF attack, we want to use that URL, our domain, so we use that. And then paste our ID in there. So if we go there, we can see the increment failed because we are that user. We paste it in here. We can see the SRC gets updated. And then now we go to the victim. Let's pull up BERT just to look at all of the requests that went through, and we should see a request for that URL we just entered. So CSRF, let's look at BERT. And we can see that there, that SRC of that image got executed. So if we go back here, we should see we completed the challenge and we have our key. And that happened without the victim knowing. Thanks for watching. Hi, and welcome to my tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be going over Security Shepherd Cross-Site Request Forgery Lesson 2. So I have Kali Linux in this VM right here. And in another VM, I have the OWASP broken web applications, and that's what we'll be running Security Shepherd through. And I have Attacker 1 and Victim 1. As the two users here. So as Attacker 1, I'll go into CSRF Lesson 2. We see our objective is to increment our counter above 0 using this request. And we see this looks pretty similar to Lesson 1, except for the post. So we'll have to inject some HTTP form using this URL. So let's just go ahead and create that real quick. Start action, get our domain. Oh. using this request. And our user ID. Throw that into the hidden. So now we need victim 1 to execute this somehow. Let's just throw that into here and see what happens. And you can see it didn't, there was some kind of data validation, didn't accept it. So now we'll want to serve this from a web page, and I'll just go ahead and do that through the broken web apps. Backup directory. Oops. Oops. So go on. Now we'll just create an HTML page using this right here, and we can do that using the here doc redirection. So, oops. Go ahead and pause this while I put the rest in. So now I have the rest in. Go ahead and end that. And we should see our file there. Now let's go ahead and test that. And we can see it there. And if we go to it, we see the increment failed. That's because it's our user. So we grab that URL that we just used. Oops. And paste that into our form here. You see the increment failed for us, however, when the victim runs it. Go ahead and we should see a post request to that URL. You can see the increment was successful. And there we can see our post request. So go back to the attacker, and we should have our key. You can see the challenge has been completed. Thanks for watching.